Welcome to this afternoon's meditation. Please find a position you can sustain for the next 20 minutes or so, where you can be relaxed but alert. You can just relax and enjoy this time. And I invite you now, if you wish, to close your eyes and to begin by listening intently to the sound of the bowl. Tone to wash over you, relaxing into the sound. Don't resist it, just relax into it. Try and feel the sound as well as listening to it. Feel it in your head, in your body. Continuing to listen intently as the tone fades away. If you haven't already closed your eyes, I invite you to do so and give your attention to the sense of hearing, continuing to listen intently to any sounds in your own environment. Similarly, relaxing into them, allowing them to wash over you, not resisting them. Seeing if you can feel those sounds as well as hear them. Sounds which are far away from you, but also sounds nearby. It's accepting that they're there. Also the sounds of your own body, breathing, swallowing. Perhaps listening very carefully, hearing that background sound of ringing or tingling that we all have in our own ears, if we listen very carefully. Just noticing it, allowing it to be there. Not resisting. In a similar way, giving your attention to the light beyond your eyelids. Relaxing into the light, allowing the light to wash over you. Another sense of the air against your skin. Temperature, how it feels, what it's like to breathe. And the sensation of the fabric of your clothing against your skin. Noticing and accepting that areas are looser or tighter. Areas where clothing may be stretched, different textures of fabric. Just letting them be. Similarly, the chair on which you're sat or bed on which you're lying, notice the points of contact. Areas of pressure, how that changes the temperature. Just paying a curious attention, non-judgmental, allowing things to be just as they are. If you've been supported by the chair bed, allowing yourself to be supported. Don't do the work the chair is doing for you. Allow yourself to sink into it. More taking the awareness of the breath, experiencing it at the tip of the nose, cool as you breathe in, warmer as you breathe out. You've got a succession of breaths, following the breath on its journey, just to experience what it's like, not changing it, not lengthening it, just allowing it to be natural. But relaxing around the path of the breath. So relaxing the nose and the sinuses and muscles of the face, cheeks, and the throat. See how that feels as you soften around the path of the breath. The neck. Chest and the back, on the shoulder area, allowing the breath to gently move the body, your ribs, sending an internal gaze down into the chest, heart and lungs. Notice how everything is gently massaged by each breath. You just soften around the path of the breath. And down to the diaphragm. And into the abdomen. Just now you can just soften the tummy muscles. How the abdomen moves to the front. Sides, even to the back a little bit. Maybe you can even feel the sensation of the breath in your arms and your hands and fingers. Notice if things feel different on the in-breath to the out-breath. Maybe the points of contact with the chair or the bed, does the sensation change there with each breath? Does the pressure change at all? Does it spread or shrink? How about the sensation of the clothing against the skin? Breathe into these sensations and notice them. Maybe even the sensation of the breath which is down the legs. Perhaps all the way to the feet. You can even experience the whole body breathing. The whole body relaxing around each breath, softening around each breath. That's good. Now, in your mind's eye, I invite you on a lovely walk around the most beautiful garden. Maybe you can call to mind some memories of beautiful gardens you visited in the past, or a completely new garden to you, an imaginary one, your own special place. The path leading down into this garden that you can begin walking now, strolling down into the garden, taking your time, you have all the time in the world, just you in your special garden. And as you stroll along, notice everything you can see, the path you're walking on, what it's like, sky above you, glorious day, and of course the textures and colours of the plants, what they're like, whether they're trees or bushes or flowers, what's lying in the path that you're walking on, taking your time to notice all the different colours and varieties, different heights. Perhaps you can hear sounds too, maybe birds calling, singing, perhaps insects buzzing amongst the plants, maybe bees collecting pollen, maybe a gentle breeze from leaves or branches, and perhaps in the distance even the sound of water tinkling from a fountain, flowing through a stream, perhaps the sound of your own footsteps as you stroll along. Maybe you can smell the flowers or the bushes or the plants, or just the freshness of the air. Perhaps even feeling fresh air in your skin, the warmth of the sun, the difference between the shade of a tree, and then warmth of the sun when you pass out into the light again. So taking your time to enjoy this lovely place. And as you stroll along, I'm going to keep you company and my voice can go with you. And I'm going to count from 1 to 10. I'd like you to notice a curious thing, that each number you can go deeper, relax, and become more and more comfortable. Go one, just enjoying the walk, deeper, relax now. Two, that's good, more and more comfortable as you stroll along, all the time in the world. Three, every step you take on this lovely walk, more and more relaxed. Four, just you and this lovely garden. Five, just this place to enjoy. Soak in the goodness of nature. Six, plants, sunlight. Breathing in the good air. Eight, more and more comfortable. Nine, deeper relax now. And 10. Just in your own pace, in this special garden that belongs only to you, you can stroll along looking at the colours, flowers, plants, and perhaps there are other features too, maybe statues or benches, whatever you want in this special place, you can explore and enjoy. Maybe there's even one of those labyrinths where you can wander. You can find different things that suddenly reveal themselves as you turn a corner. A piece of stonework, or a statue, or a special flower, bush, or tree. Always working your way towards the center, where there may be something particularly beautiful waiting for you to discover. And as you stroll along, you know that you're getting nearer to the heart of the garden. Everything becomes more and more peaceful, quieter and calmer, as if every step you take takes you to a more peaceful place. Every breath you take of this wonderful fresh air relaxes you, energizes your body. It can feel so good. And I've no idea how deeply you relax today, but one thing I do know is that there is a wisdom in your own unconscious mind that you will only relax to the degree to which your own unconscious mind knows will give you the most benefit. That means you will relax a little or to a very deep level, according to your own need and according to your own internal wisdom, your own guidance system. So you can trust in that and allow it to happen. And you can just be curious to notice how that feels as you stroll along, enjoying the beautiful things that are to be seen, the colours and the textures, the warmth of the sun you can experience, and the sounds of the garden, and the smells. You just enjoy the walk. As you stroll along, the sound of running water becomes gradually louder as you realize that the heart of the garden is a beautiful water feature. Making your way towards that and allowing it to reveal itself until you can see it, water flowing into a pond, maybe there's a fountain. You can see the sun reflecting off the water, and if you look into the clear water, perhaps there are even fish swimming. I don't know what your particular place or garden is like. It will be unique just to you. Maybe you can even feel water spray on your face as you draw closer. Perhaps now for a moment you can find somewhere to sit. Just enjoy the beauty of this own, your own special place. And as you just enjoy this lovely place, I'm reminded of a story. When you come across water, this story involves water. I'll just share that story with you now. It's a story of a river. And the river, like many rivers, began its life, its journey high up on a mountain. The rain and snow came down, the ice melted, and a little bubbling brook began to make its way down the steep, high mountain, bouncing over stones and rocks, bubbling along, full of energy, full of joy. And gradually it was joined by other streams and brooks, till eventually it became a strong torrent rushing down that steep mountain. Full of energy, full of life, full of youth and joy, feeling strong, feeling energy. And eventually the gradient leveled off, and the stream was joined by others. It eventually became a deep, wide river. making its way towards the lowlands, where it began to slow down, but by this time it was deep and strong. And its journey took it on many winding courses, and because the river was so deep and strong and powerful, nothing could stand in its way. It could gouge great valleys. It could even push rocks out of the way. It could uproot trees if it couldn't find its way over or around. It could dig under into the earth and then emerge again. The river felt invincible. And this was a time of its life when it was deeply fulfilled. People made villages along its banks. They went on journeys in boats. They washed and swam and fished. And the river felt it was contributing to life and to flourishing. It was loved, it was wanted, it was important. And so it felt deeply fulfilled. And it continued its journey in contentment. Until eventually one day, the river came to the desert. And when it met those hot sands, those great dunes stretching for miles, the river thought to itself, nothing has stopped my progress before. I'll find my way through this obstacle just as I have in the past. I'll throw my mighty waters at these great sand dunes. That's exactly what the river did. But the sand just swallowed the river up. And so the river, in all its might and strength, gathered its forces and threw itself at the hot sands again, only to find itself soaked up. And eventually the river was exhausted. And it thought to itself, after all this time, after all my remarkable journey, does it all end here? Is this where my journey stops? And in exhaustion, the river fell into a sort of quiet despair and became very quiet. And in the quiet, the river heard a small voice. And the voice said, many rivers have tried to cross the desert in this way. None have succeeded. But there is a way if you take my advice and allow me to help you. So the river said, who are you? And the voice said, I am the desert. And I'm willing to offer you help if you will accept it. So the river had never needed anybody's help or advice or assistance before, but being completely stuck, the river said, please give me your advice. And so the desert spoke. He said, this is not a journey you can make in your own strength. Now is the time to just let go. You must allow the sun to beat down upon you and to lift you high into the air. And you must allow the wind to blow upon you and to carry you across the miles of dunes and hot sands high up in the air. And then your journey will continue. And the desert finished giving his advice, and the river listened carefully. But frankly, the river was terrified. It had never put itself into anybody else's hands before. But what else was there? What else could it do? And so the river thanked the desert for its advice. And the river relaxed and became deeply still and very quiet and calm. And it felt the sun beating down upon it. It allowed the sun to warm it. It didn't resist. And in no time at all, the sun was lifting the river high into the air as vapour. And then the river felt the wind blowing upon it and found itself flying at great speed, high above the desert sands. And from that great height, far, far in the distance, for the first time, it saw something it had never seen before. It glimpsed the ocean. And it realized where its journey had been taking it all this time. And soon the air began to cool again, and the river found itself turning back into droplets and falling on a new mountain range. And before long it was bubbling and gurgling and rushing down another steep gradient as its journey continued. And now back to your journey around your beautiful garden. But you can continue now. Continuing to stroll, breathe that good air, and listen to the sounds all around, to enjoy the sight and colours and textures, the warmth of the sun. A few moments more, soaking in the good. And as you just enjoy this walk for a few moments more, your own unconscious mind can learn everything it wants to learn and needs to learn from this experience and from the story of the river. And I would like to invite you once more to listen to the sound of the bowl. Listen intently to that sound. As the sound fades, when you're ready, and only when your unconscious mind knows you've learned everything you need to learn from this session, only then opening your eyes and going on with your day. So listening very intently now. Conscious mind knows how to bring back with you all the peace and calm from this lovely place, bringing peace and calm back into the place where you live, bringing the peace back into the day, so you can continue to enjoy a deep stillness